all you need to know. The Bloomberg Quint podcast that prepares you for the day's business. Good morning. It's nearly the weekend. Here's everything you need to know at the start of your Friday. I'm Alex Matthew, and this is the All You Need to Know podcast. Today is the 2nd of November. US President Donald Trump said he had a productive conversation with Chinese President Xi Jinping on trade and North Korea ahead of a highly anticipated meeting planned between the two leaders at the G20 summit in Argentina this month. Trump said on Twitter that the discussions with China were moving along nicely. India and South Korea agreed with the US on the outline of deals that would allow them to keep importing some Iranian oil, according to Asian officials with knowledge of the matter. No final decision has been made, and an announcement is unlikely before US sanctions on Iran are reimposed on the 5th of November. That opens a possibility that the terms could still be modified or the deals scrapped entirely. The waivers would ensure that at least some Iranian oil continues to flow to the global market, potentially calming fears of a supply crunch. Oil fell to the lowest in more than 6 months on Thursday on the news and amid signs that US supply is accelerating. In international markets, US equity benchmarks ended higher, with the S&P 500 and Dow gaining about 1% each and the Nasdaq rising about 1.75%. This despite a sharp 7% fall in Apple share price in extended trading. Apple gave an underwhelming forecast for the key holiday period, suggesting weaker than expected demand for the pricier new iPhones. The company further stoked concerns by saying it will stop reporting unit sales of the iPhone. Asian stocks are trading mostly positive this morning, with the Nikkei gaining about 1.3% and the Kospi gaining about 2% in early trade. On to news from back home. For the third time since August, India extended the deadline for the imposition of higher customs duty on 29 US products. These are now slated to come into effect mid-December. Meanwhile, the US on Thursday revoked duty-free concessions on the import of at least 50 Indian products, mostly from the handloom and agriculture sector. The government on Thursday sold 3.2% stake in Coal India, which will fetch 5,300 crore rupees. The government had planned to sell 3% stake in the coal major, with the option of selling another 6% as part of a greenshoe option. Four High Court Chief Justices were on Thursday night elevated to the Supreme Court within 48 hours of the collegium recommending their names to the government. These include Justice Gupta of the Madhya Pradesh High Court, Justice Rastogi of the Tripura High Court, Justice Shah of the Patna High Court, and Justice Reddy of the Gujarat High Court. Financial services company MasterCard has said that data localization guidelines issued by the Indian government will make the digital payments business expensive and inefficient to provide safety, security, and analytics to Indian banks and merchants. With that, it's over to Darshan Mehta for the trade setup for the day in India. Morning, Darshan. Positive cues from overseas.
Hi, Alex. Good morning. Good morning, everyone. We are in the midst of strong global cues. The US markets ended positive. Crude is down for the fifth day. It's down 16% from the recent highs and now trading at the 200 DMA. Even metals on the LME did manage to rally. But we're in the midst of the earnings season, so Axis Bank, Hindalco, Indian Oil and NTPC are the four nifty companies that will report numbers today. In terms of other numbers today, Alkem Labs, Bharat Forge, Bata, Equitas, Godrej Consumer, Oracle Finance, Punjab National Bank, Petronet LNG, Sun TV, Tata Chemicals, all of them will report numbers. Some of the numbers that came out after market hours: GSK Consumer, Aarti Industries, Trent, Tata Communication and SRF, all of them posted strong numbers, while HPCL posted a weak set of numbers. The two auto sales that came out after market hours: Eicher Motors, strong set of numbers. If looking at the numbers, 70,441 was the monthly sales. Hero MotoCorp, the sales was 7,34,668. Pretty strong set of numbers coming in even from Hero MotoCorp. Indraprastha Gas, in a notification, has said that the Supreme Court has suggested that the company to take over the supply of natural gas in Gurgaon district from Haryana City Gas Distribution, and that's why the counter was up in trade yesterday. Deepak Nitrite commences operations at the phenol and acetone plant. The plant has the capacity to manufacture 2 lakh MTPA of phenol and 1,20,000 MTPA of the co-product, which is acetone. And finally, Inox Leisure Board approves to issue 64 lakh share equity shares on a preferential basis to the promoter, Gujarat Fluorochemicals, at a floor price of 241.71 per share. But there's much more you need to know before trade actually starts. For that, log on to our website, BloombergQuint.com, and click on the All You Need to Know tab, and you'll be prepared for morning trade.
Thanks, Darshan. And as always, thank you for listening in. This is Alex Matthew signing off. Have an absolutely wonderful weekend.
Sachin Tendulkar, Virat Kohli, Don Bradman, and now Cyrus Brocha. Okay, probably not in the right company. I mean, Don Bradman is Australian. But it's called Cyrus Says, a wonderful show about everything. Find the show on the IVM Podcast app, ivmpodcast.com, or wherever you listen to podcasts.